Climate change, ignoring Mother Nature's warnings. The majority of scientists around the world agree that humans are largely to blame for the warming of our planet. Over the past 50 years, temperatures on Earth have increased at a higher rate than ever recorded. In order to prevent excess greenhouse gases from trapping heat in our atmosphere, we need to change our lifestyles. By reducing our carbon footprint and switching to clean forms of energy, there is a chance we will be able to extend our stay on our planet. Despite freakish weather like heat waves, droughts, and hurricanes, tackling climate change has not been a priority for some world leaders. As a presidential candidate, Donald Trump said he was not a big believer in man-made climate change. Some of his supporters, including a handful of scientists, were even accused of taking part in a climate cover-up. Those who benefit financially from oil, gas, and coal industries often deny the need for clean energy alternatives. By casting doubt on science, a few skeptics have caused a large number of people to question whether man-made climate change even exists. Ignoring a time-sensitive topic like the environment creates a vicious cycle. If the public doesn't rate the environment as a major concern, world leaders won't either. Environmentalists always said that the first place humans would see undeniable evidence of global warming would be in the Arctic. In 2012, the summer sea ice in the Arctic was at a record low. Ice experts have warned that sea ice in the Arctic will likely be non-existent within a few years. Instead of being concerned by these dangerous signs of global warming, some business thinkers are already considering potential opportunities. After all, open waters will lead to new shipping channels. We'll need stronger sunscreen products too. Climate change affects the whole planet, yet the world's leaders can't agree on what to do about it. Many leaders from have-not countries think they should be off the hook. They don't believe their people contributed to the problem, and they want wealthy nations to fix it. Developed nations aren't always as wealthy as they look. They're in debt, at war, and addicted to consumption. On May 24, 2019, hundreds of thousands of students walked out of schools around the world in a global climate strike, protesting inaction by their governments. Will today's youth spark a climate revolution?